The Noah's Ark, we building and building, the flood coming, but they will not listen. The seed and great army, they worry about sinning. Shout out to bishop and deacons. Hold tight, keep your mind on the mission. Facing saints, just hoping and wishing. Waiting on our redemption. Hey, we just waiting on our redemption.
While I wait on my redemption, I want to play my position. Water boy, Lord willing. Fourth quarter, gotta kill it.
Right now, if you know this, when you say you know better, you gotta do better.
Verse 22.
When you know better, you gotta do better, bro. Come look, get for it.
Give me something, man.
You stumbling around here, and these folks flying around this corner, but you get hit by a cop.
Bro, I've been standing in the same place I've been standing in.
Read verse 22.
Verse 22. Woe to them that are mighty to drink wine, and their men of strength to mingle strong drink.
So that's just a warning, bro, about the drinking. You can drink, but you just ain't supposed to drink too much, bro. You know what I'm saying? And now, right now, bro. Okay, huh? Okay, I'll pray. Do you understand it? So now, what we were going back to, go back to group 3 and 10. So I just want you to check this out and listen to what we're saying. Because we're trying to show our people who we are according to the Bible, bro. That's what we're doing. We out here reading the Bible and showing our people who we are.
You got to be authentic.
All right, group 3 and 10. All right, and I'm trying to, straight up with you, bro.
This is my family. Y'all my family.
You right.
Because y'all speaking on what I love. That's what I told my wife.
All right, group 3 and 10.
Let me step out the car.
Baruch, chapter 3 and verse 10. How happeneth it, Israel? That thou art in thy enemy's land.
So the Bible said, how happened, sister? The Bible said, how happened it, Israel? Israel, how did this happen? Read, that you are what?
In thy enemy's land.
It said, Israel, how did it happen that now you in your enemy's land?
Ask y'all something.
You can ask me something. Hold your question. I'm going to get your question. I'm going to read. Let me bring this scripture.
It's really gone.
It said, how happened it that you in your enemy's land? How you end up over here in your enemy's land? Well, God's asking us. Read.
That thou art waxing old in a strange country.
It said, now you done got old in a strange country, meaning old, weak, and feeble. God, and when you look at the state of our people, we're not the strong people that we really are. We stronger than the other nations, but in our mind, we weak and feeble. We believe anything that these people tell us. We believe that voting going to help us. We vote for the next slave master.
Ask something, bro.
Okay, brother, you got a question. Okay, ask me. What's your question, bro? Ask me. All right, I'm listening to you, bro.
You. God's son. It's God's son. God is our father.
Okay.
God is our savior. God is our everything. Listen.
I'm trying to listen to what your question is, bro.
Help in your life, brother. Wife's name.
Bro, what's brother? What's your question?
Hold on, wait. I'm gonna make up my name. Carolyn. Did you wanna have sex with Shakur?
That's adultery, bro. Give me that Exodus 20. Give me that Exodus 20. I'm gonna show you. So you said if I got a wife, will I go have sex with such and such Shakurita, the next woman? No. Watch this. And I'm gonna show you why. Because God, the reason. I'm going to go back to Baruch 3 and 10. The reason why we over here is because God gave us commandments to keep, and we broke his commandments. God made a deal with his people, a covenant with his people that said, keep my commandments, I'm going to put you above everybody, break God's commandment, and I'm going to put you below. Exodus 20:14.
The book of Exodus, chapter 20, verse 14. Thou shalt not commit adultery.
He said, thou shalt not commit adultery. So, you ask me would I do that? No. You know why? Because stuff like that is why we ended up over here in slavery, brought over here on slave ships, having to serve our enemies for food, water, clothing. God did that to us. God did that. That's a punishment.
That's right.
So if I do that, guess what? I'm going to continue in that punishment, and right. I'm not trying to do that. Right. So go back to Luke 3 and 10.
Hold on, wait. I want to ask you, what do you feel about the law of the land?
Give me Romans 13:1. Romans 13. The brother asked a good question. He said, what do you feel about the law of the land? Let's see. Let's consult God's word and let me figure out what God said I should think about the law of the land. All right.
I love this.
All right.
I love it.
Romans 13:1. Read.
I think y'all give me a bit, huh?
The book of Romans, chapter 13, verse 1.
This is concerning the law of the land. What do I feel about the law of the land? This is what God said. Read.
Let every soul be subject unto the higher power.
God said, I put you over here under these people for your punishment, for you to get right and repent. So he said, now let every soul be subject to the higher power. The higher power is your local government. They put your police out here. They put your laws out here. God said, be subject to that thing. Read.
Let every soul be subject unto the higher powers. For there is no power but of God.
He said, be subject to that thing. Be subject to the laws and the higher power, because there is no power but of God. God said, I put that in place. They would not have that power to make these laws and to govern you unless I gave it to them.
Bring it out.
So God said, you follow that, because I put you under that condition. Read.
The powers that be are ordained of God.
Those powers that be are ordained of God. So that's why you stop at the red light when you see a red light. That's why you go when the light turns green. That's a law. You're going to follow this. That's a law. You're going to follow this. Okay, that's why you ain't out here. You don't run up in here and steal, because guess what? You know the police gonna lock you up. The land. But guess what? God said those are ordained of God. And guess what? The laws of this land is based off the laws in this Bible. Thou shalt not steal.
Speak the next line.
Read.
Let every soul unto the higher powers, for there is no power but of God. The powers that be are ordained of God.
Read.
Whosoever therefore resisted the power.
It said, whoso resist the power, so as you don't stop at that red light, read.
Resisted the ordinance of God.
And you resist the ordinance of God. Now what happened when you resist the ordinance of God? Read.
And they that resist shall receive to themselves damnation.
You're going to receive to yourself damnation. Meaning you're going to catch that ticket. You break a law of the land. Guess what? The police going to come lock you up. They're going to lock you and put you away in 201. That's what's going to happen.
Okay. You don't got to say my name.
All right, brother. Hey, good talking to you, bro. Did you get a flyer? Did you get one of the flyers?
Give me one.
Get it, brother. Somebody get it, brother. Five. So, sister, check this out. Go back to Baruch 3 and 10.
I ain't no sister.
No, I'm talking to sister across the street. She's been sitting over here listening diligently for about 45 minutes an hour now.
Check it out.
Trying to get some understanding. All right.
That's what I'm saying.
Baruch 3 and 10.
That was hard.
The book of Baruch, chapter 3, verse 10. How happened it, Israel?
He said, how happened it, Israel?
That thou art in thine enemy's land.
That you in your enemy's land. How did this happen?
That thou art waxing old in a strange country.
That you got weak over here in captivity. Read.
That thou art defiled with the dead.
Now you defiled. Now they taught you, guess what? They taught you to eat pork, shrimp, crab, lobster, all those things against the dietary law. That's why, guess what? When we do those things, God puts disease on us. That's why you end up with blood pressure problems, hypertension. God said, when you break my laws, you don't follow my dietary law, there's punishment for that too. Read.
That thou art counted with them that go down into the grave.
He said, now you counted with them that go down to the street corner.
Me and my wife,
what's
right
what God say?
From the heart of you.
Matthew 6 and...
No, I don't read from no
book. Give me Matthew 6 and 6, read. This, look, brother, this right here is, I got to go to the Bible, okay? Because I don't speak my own words, and I follow what God says. Right, so you said, brother, pray for me. Let's see what God has to say about what you just asked me to do. Right. Read.
The book of Matthew, chapter 6, verse 6.
Bring it out.
But thou, when thou prayest.
God said, when you pray, this is Jesus Christ talking right here, the black Messiah, the black man that's recorded in the Bible. God said, when you pray.
But thou, when thou prayest, enter into thy closet.
Go into a private place and pray.
And when thou hast shut thy door, pray to thy Father, which is in secret. And thy Father, which seeth in secret, shall reward thee openly.
Go into a private place and pray. That's what God said. And your Father that sees you in private will reward you openly. Now let's concern it. We right here out here on the street corner. Give me that part. Give me that part.
You can't play with me.
All right, read.
And my God.
See what, you know what I want? Right here. Give me that here.
Man, you was confused about my God.
The book of Matthew chapter 6 verse 5.
COVID-19 the other day.
Verse 5. And when thou prayest, it's concerning you, said you want me to pray for you right here on the street corner. This is what Christ said, dude.
And when thou prayest, thou shalt not be as the hypocrites are.
Read again.
And when thou prayest, thou shalt not be as the hypocrites are.
God said, when you pray, we shouldn't be like hypocrites. What do the hypocrites do when they pray? Listen, bro.
They complain.
Listen. I'm finishing. Listen what the Bible says. This is what hypocrites do when they pray. God said, when you pray, don't be like the hypocrites. When you
I
do.
Am what I
and
am.
And when thou prayest, thou shalt not be as the hypocrites are, for they love to pray standing in the synagogues and in the corners of the streets.
He said, God said they love to pray. They hypocrites. They love to pray in the synagogues. That's in the front of the churches or in the corners of the streets where everybody can see them in. Read.
That they may be seen of men.
Where everybody can see me, so they can say, ooh, they so holy. They praying for this brother out here on the street corner. God said, don't do that. He said, don't do that. You're not supposed to be seen. Like, look, he said, go in private, pray to me, and I'm going to reward you openly. Doing this right here, I ain't trying to look out, trying to look extra holy for nobody out here. I want my people to keep the commandments and become what holiness really is.
That's what love is.
I'm loving you right now. I'm loving you by showing you what God says to you.
That's right.
Me. All right, read
you
it again.
You love me.
That's right. He
loves
you.
And when thou prayest,
he loves
you. Thou shalt not be as the hypocrites are, for they love to pray standing in the synagogue and in the corners of the streets, that they may be seen of men. Verily I say unto you, they have their reward.
God said, if you do that, you already got your reward. Everybody saw you. Now, that's what you want to do. That's what you wanted. You wanted everybody to see you. You wanted everybody to see me praying for you. God said, you got your reward in this. But I want the reward that God's going to give me in private. That way, when I step out, everybody know God just blessed me. Because you can see the blessings of God on me.
Because
that's what I'm talking
blessing.
About. We're not supposed to do this. We're not supposed to be out here
it's
praying in the middle of the street for
from
you.
God.
This is the blessing
to do
right here. This is how you're going
to
be blessed, bro. Give me
what
Revelation 21.
What we're trying to do is save souls. We're so on the block in front of
21
everybody.
And 14. This is how you be blessed of God. Everybody say I'm blessed and highly favored on in Sunday, which they not keeping God's Sabbath day.
Live that way.
So you got to live that way. So
we're
now,
talking.
What are some of God's commandments? What's God's commandments? You said forget the talking. You know what? Cool. I don't even want to talk. I'm going to let the Bible speak. Let's go to some of God's commandments.
Said, what's God's
come
commandments?
On. Give me a... Give me,
know what God's commandments is.
Give me the Saturday. Give me Exodus 20. We finna get on for God's commandments. Because he said forget the talking. I don't like talking. My words ain't talk about nothing. God's word is what everything is. All right? So let's read God's word and let God talk. Read Exodus 20 and 4. The seventh day.
Eight. The book of Exodus, chapter 20, verse 8. Remember the Sabbath day.
God said, remember the Sabbath day. This is one of his commandments. How you going to be blessed? Remember the Sabbath day. Why he say remember? Because he know Negroes is going to forget.
That's right.
You're going to go into slavery. The white man is going to tell you that the Sabbath was on Sunday when it ain't Sunday. So he said, look, read the scripture and remember.
Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy.
And you got to keep it holy. Read.
6 days shall thou labor and do all thy work.
God said you got 6 days to labor and do all your work. This is a commandment we're going over, a commandment on how you're going to be blessed. 6 days you got to labor and do all your work. Read.
But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God.
But the seventh day, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Look on your calendar, pull your phone out, sister. What's the seventh day?
Oh, sister.
Saturday, seventh day.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.